Brent here with Bring Your Own Tools, and on today's episode, we are installing an 800-pound lift in the garage. If you want to learn how to do it, keep on watching. Let's get started. Now, this project starts and finishes with this beautiful hoist that I picked up on Amazon for $150. It's from Parts AM, and it is an electric hoist crane unit, which has a 110 outlet plug, which is perfect and standard, as well as a nice handy little built-in remote control for up and down, as well as emergency stops. Now, I chose this unit for a number of different reasons, but inevitably it came with quite a few accessories, these straps, as well as a switchover tool for doubling your weight load capacity. Now, if you're using a single line as it's actually attached right now to the device, that can only hold 440 pounds, but if you attach the double line as shown in this picture, it can hold over 880 pounds. Now, the only end that I purchased separately was this 2-foot long metal strut that I picked up at Home Depot for $10. And this is just an easy way to actually attach the entire lift to the ceiling joists themselves. Now, make sure to leave links in the description box below on where to purchase all these items, but let's get to installing. Now, what I first do is actually just line up the strut against the ceiling joists and mark my hole locations that I'll be pre-drilling prior to installing. And yes, I do know there's a bit of a mess with all the insulation you can see right there, but this is the beginning of a whole garage makeover series that I cannot wait to get to, so that'll be taken care of in future videos to come. Now, as for hardware, I'm using these ledger lock bolts that are heavy duty and actually designed for decks, so I know they're strong and they can take some abuse. I do suggest adding a large washer for these bolts just to make sure you have even distribution and the maximum hold capacity you can possibly get through two of these bolts. I then pre-drill my holes, and if you feel like you want more security than just two bolts, then I suggest getting a longer metal strut in order to fasten multiple locations across the joists versus just the two joists. You can have approximately 6 to 7 to 8 joists if you'd like to, and that would just evenly distribute the weight accordingly. Now, this lift is not light, so I wanted to make it easier on myself by fastening one side of the strut to the joist and then slipping on the actual lift into place. Then after I had the lift in place, I then just attached the second bolt to the joist and fastened tightly after that. Now, throughout this entire garage makeover series, I want to emphasize organization as well as cord management, and therefore I'm going to use these staples just to manage all the excess cords overhead, and therefore I won't be tripping over them and I won't have to worry about them later on. But guess what? After we have the cords taken care of and we plug it in, we are done! Now, the really nice thing about this system is the fact that you can have it up and running in merely an hour, and the fact that you have an extremely strong helping hand by your side at all times makes it extremely valuable, especially when it's just me in the shop, because I can lay my product on the table. I can even drive my truck into position and load up my truck from there. Now, just remember, if you do want to double your weight load capacity, you have to connect into the lift and then assemble your pulley hoist hook, which does come with kit, which is always appreciated. Now, that is one beautiful, sexy beast. Oh yeah. Thank you all so much for watching. Please like the video, please subscribe to this channel, and please check out one of my other videos. You just might like it. This channel is all about helping others learn how to build and create on a weekly basis. Till next time. Home workout quarantine is in full effect. Yes.